Hey, hey, hey! Happy Tuesday! So I am here today, being back to being consistent. And typically, remember, like Tuesday, Thursday afternoons, I usually go live and just talk to you guys about what's on my mind. And I've been getting away from that. My park, and there's some people walking by. You know, real life, right? So today I wanted to talk to you guys about mindset and personal perception, right? So, you know, I stepped on the scale this morning because I accidentally left the scale at our old house. And you know, we are now in an apartment. So I accidentally left my scale at the house. So I had to pick it up last night, so I didn't have a scale to step on all weekend. So this morning when I was stepping on the scale, I was kind of shocked because I really was not, the number was not as high as I thought it was going to be. This is all about mindset and perception, right? So, you know, I didn't make great decisions over the weekend with my food. I did not work out over the weekend, but we did a lot of physical activity, right? And I dialed it back in for one day yesterday. And, you know, I was probably about 5 pounds less than I was expecting. So, you know, we perceive how we're doing to be way worse than the reality of how we're really doing. Because, you know, I could have just kept being like, you know, you made horrible decisions. Just not gonna get back on track. I'm not gonna get up and work out today. I'm not gonna eat right today. I could have gone and gone through the drive-thru, gotten fast food, made bad decisions because, you know, my number wasn't as high as I was expecting it to be, but it wasn't great, right? Still 215 pounds, you know, I got like 55 pounds to lose to get down to my size 8, but you know, people look at me and they're like, you don't have 55 pounds to lose. Well, I wear it well. I learn how to dress for my body type because that is a huge, right? Dressing for a body type. So even though we're on this journey, we still feel good about ourselves, because if we feel crappy about ourselves and we hate ourselves, that's when we self-sabotage. And that is when I have tended to be a self-sabotager, is when I'm just down on myself and I'm saying, you are a failure, you can't do this, you're just doing a horrible job. That is when I just get down on myself. And then, you know, I talk to my friends, I talk to my team, I talk to my husband, and you know, it's okay if you make bad decisions, you can get back on track tomorrow, right? So that is like a huge deal for me, is my mindset and self-love, and to love myself where I am now, even if I'm 55 pounds over where I want to be. I'm still 45 pounds down from when I had the twins. And, you know, that pregnancy was very, very rough on my body, right? Carrying two babies is tough on a body, two babies at one time. And they're each 7.5 pounds when they were born. So that is a lot of baby in there. So yeah, I had about 100 pounds to lose. And, you know, I got to look at the positive. I lost almost 50 pounds. That is where I look at the positive. I keep my mindset positive. I feel good about what I've accomplished because, you know, I'm a working mom. I'm a business owner. I have two kids, and the older kid is very, very busy. He has a lot of activities. He also has type 1 diabetes. You know, so we are crazy busy. And I have to be sure that even though we're busy, I'm putting myself first. Because that is what I was not doing this weekend. I was not putting myself first. I was putting the move first, taking care of the people that were helping us move, trying to rush to get everything put away. As it's not the end of the world that everything is unpacked yet, right? We really only need to unpack the things that are 100% necessary to use, because we're moving in 3 months, right? So yesterday they dug the hole for our new house. How exciting. 10 to 12 weeks, it should be done. And we will be out of that apartment for good, and we are not moving for a long time. At least till my daughter graduates high school, which is like 15 years away. So we are not moving again. No way. I hate moving. I just, it wreaked havoc on my body. and I just don't like it. So, but we're getting through apartment living with four people and a dog. We are handling living in a different city. We are back on track again, back on track with our eating, back on track with workouts, just back on track with our schedule. You know, it is going to take a few tweaks, but it's summer, so we have a little more flexibility. But, you know, it's all about the mindset, guys, right? So I could be like, this sucks. I don't want to live in an apartment for 3 months. I hate it. Why do we have to do this? Or I could look at it like it's an adventure. We're closer to family. We're closer to the community pool. It's just one summer. There's cool playgrounds there. There's a basketball court. Just look at the positives, you know, because that's really what I want to talk to you guys about, mindset. And let's look at the positive part of things, because if you're not being positive, you are just thinking negative of yourself. You think you can't do it. You think that you're a failure. You think that you failed every time in the past. You're just not going to be successful. So, you know, think about why you want to lose weight. Think about why you want to be healthy. Think about why you want to reach any goal, and just freaking do the thing, right? So have a good day, everybody. I will talk to you soon. Bye.